Finally, a dual monitor mount that doesn't suck. Howdy, howdy guys, Ponchado here, and today we're taking a look at the Z2-3D gas spring dual monitor mount from Arctic. Wait, Arctic? Yep, the same company that designed CPU coolers is breaking into the desk accessory market. A weird jump for sure, but I'm always cool with companies trying new things. And if they put out the same quality here as they do with their coolers, I think we're in for a treat. Thanks to Arctic for sending this out for review. The Z2-3D is compatible with monitors between 13 and 27 inches with either 75mm or 100mm VESA mounts and up to 8kg or about 17 pounds per arm. It also has a 4-port powered USB 3 hub built into the base so you can have plenty of connections on your desk where they're easy to reach. The box has most of the specs you might need, but I'll cover them in detail in a bit. Inside the box, you'll find a very tightly packed amalgamation of all the separate pieces with the parts list and instructions right on top. They look pretty complicated, but the directions are detailed and well written, so they're pretty easy to follow. There's a lot of pieces and components to unpack, but once you have it all laid out, it's easy to figure out basically how it all goes together. First things first, you need to attach the base to the desk mount. All the tools you'll need, except for a Phillips head screwdriver, are included with the mount. Once the base is attached to the desk mount, you tighten the clamp underneath so it all holds snugly to the desk. The desk mount can handle tables as thick as 6.5cm or about 2.5 inches. After that, you thread the center mounting pole into the base and then tighten a tiny set screw in the back to keep the pole from coming loose. Finally, you slide the pole clamp onto the pole and tighten it. This basically acts as a second level of support to keep the monitor arms from slipping down the pole. One cool little detail here is that the tightening arm isn't just fixed, you can pull it out and rotate it to a better position, which is especially useful if you have everything put together and need to make adjustments. Next, you put together the monitor arms. The VESA mount plates attach to the gas springs with a single large screw and nut. The nut is held in place to make threading the screws easier. Once these are on, you can start assembling the whole arm. Starting at the pole connector, which holds the arms to the pole, you simply slide the lower arms on, hold a cap on top, and thread one of the spring screws in through the bottom. The process is the same for attaching the gas springs to the lower arms. Put them together, hold the cap on top, and thread the screw in from the bottom. It is a little awkward to hold the whole floppy construction while you're trying to tighten the screws, but it's not too difficult. Once the arms are built, you just slide them on the pole, tighten another set screw in the back, and it's all held in place. The next step is to attach your monitors to the arms. Arctic provides M4 and M5 screws in both 12mm and 30mm lengths, along with plastic spacers in case the back of your monitor is curved and the mounts can't sit flush. Because of all that, the Z2-3D is compatible with basically any VESA mountable monitor out there. To attach the monitors, I set them face down on my desk and held the mounts against the back of the monitor, rather than trying to hold up the monitor and risk dropping it. You'll want to set the base of the arms all the way down so they can be lined up easily. Tighten the screws down all the way, and the monitors are safely attached. With the monitors in place, the next thing you need to do is adjust the tension on all the joints so everything is flexible but still holds in place. You want to set the tension on the gas springs first, basically how hard the arms pull up, so your monitor doesn't spring back when you push it down. These are set with a screw near the base to increase or decrease their lift depending on how heavy your monitor is. Simply adjust the tension until your monitor stays where you set it. Next is the tilt adjustment. The screw for this is kind of hidden behind a plastic cap, and like the gas springs, you simply adjust it until the mount can hold the monitor in whatever orientation you want. Finally, you set the pivot resistance with the screw that holds the monitor mount to the arm. If you want to lock these adjustments in place, the pivot and tilt screws can be tightened until they're locked, and the joints between the gas spring and lower arm and between the lower arm and base can be locked in place with a set screw. Underneath each gas spring arm are two plastic clips for cable management, but the lower arms don't have clips like this. A minor issue, but it would have been nice to have the option. There's also a flexible plastic clip for holding wires to the pole. A nice, simple design. The four USB ports in the base connect to your computer with a single 2-meter or 6-foot USB cable, and power for the USB ports is provided by a standalone DC adapter, also a 6-foot cable. The connection port for the power adapter is a pretty tight fit, but that means you don't have to worry about it coming unplugged. Because of the gas springs and mounting, flexibility for adjustment is really extensive. The lower arms can swivel about 270 degrees around the base, the gas spring arms can swivel 360 degrees, the monitors can swivel 180 degrees on their mounts, tilt 45 degrees up or down with the gas springs all the way up, or about 90 degrees with the gas springs level, and pivot 360 degrees for switching between landscape and vertical. The gas springs give you 15 inches or 38 centimeters of vertical adjustment, and the center pole offers about 8 inches. which allows the monitor mounts to be as high as 25 inches or 64 centimeters above the surface of the table. Past that, the arms can reach 2 feet or 60 centimeters from the base when fully extended. That gives you a ridiculous amount of adjustability. Also, one interesting feature is that the monitors maintain their tilt as you move the screen up and down, so you don't have to readjust it when you change their height. Kinda cool. Now the specs say the max screen size is 27 inches, but if you're willing to sacrifice some range of motion, these arms can fit screens way larger. This is a picture with the arm set straight out to the side with my 23-inch and 24-inch monitors. I think you'd run into the weight limit, 8 kilograms or 17.5 pounds per monitor, before you found a screen that physically didn't fit. As for the possible layouts, you can do just about whatever you want. Both screens rotated vertically is no problem, one screen vertical is fine too. You can of course have both screens side by side, and if you're one of those people, you can have the screens on top of each other. If your setup is like mine and your desk backs up to a wall, the position of the arms becomes important. With the monitors side by side and all the way back, the arms stick out about 8 inches or 20 centimeters from the back of the desk. With the monitors offset from center, the arms can stay flush with the back of the desk, which is how I'll have mine set up. After getting everything set up and the cables more or less managed, here is the result. I really appreciate that the Z2-3D's base is a plain, unobtrusive design and basically everything except the pole is black. Another benefit is that the base only sticks out very slightly from the desk, so you can have it right up against the wall with no issues. The USB ports are set far enough apart from each other that you shouldn't have any issues with large plugs. One slight but important oversight that I noticed is that on the underside of the base, there are no foam pads or rubber bumpers to keep it from scratching your desk. Since basically all the weight of the monitors is going to be concentrated on this little area, as I found out, it'll gouge the top of your desk like this. Whoops. The good news is it's easy to avoid this with self-adhesive felt or rubber bumpers, the same kind you'd stick on a kitchen cabinet or drawer to keep it from slamming. I just stuck 4 bumpers on, one under each screw on the base, to keep it from scratching again. With the bumpers installed, no scratches. Easy breezy. Now if you just want a short list of what's good and what isn't, here are the pros and cons. For the pros, the first and foremost is adjustability. The Z2-3D gives you a huge range of motion and options for setups. I especially love how much height adjustment it offers, which is a big limitation of many other monitor mounts I've seen and used. Second, this is very competitively priced for a dual monitor gas spring mount. You can easily spend several hundred more on ergonomic equipment like this, so it's great that this is priced so low, since so many people would benefit from having a more ergonomic workspace or battle station. Third, having 4 USB ports on the base really extends connectivity for computers with a limited number of built-in USB ports, and having them up on the desk puts them in a really convenient spot. As for the cons, there's really only one, and it's more of a mishap than a design flaw. All monitor mounts should, actually need to, come with some kind of cushioning on the base so they won't scratch your desk. It's a super simple fix at home and only requires about a dollar spent on felt bumpers, but it would have been better for it to just be set up like that right out of the box. But hey, that's what reviews are for. In sum, if you're looking for a highly adjustable monitor mount, or if you just want more flexibility for different monitor setups, Arctic Z2-3D is a fantastic choice. The Z2-3D can be had for only $110, which is much less than many other gas spring mounts. Arctic also has a single monitor version, the Z1-3D, for about $80. If you want to pick up one for yourself, links are in the description. Oh yeah, Arctic also threw in this funny little USB fan. It's called the Some Air Light, get it? Summer and air? Punny. Anyway, it's just a little fan for cooling you off at your desk. It comes in a cloth bag and it's surprisingly well built. In fact, I'm of the opinion that they probably spent too much time designing this. It's a 92mm fan, 900 to 2100 RPM, mounted on a flexible cable, and has a little ring for turning it on and setting the fan speed. Fancy. Oh, and the USB cable can snap into place on the side of the fan, so it won't get knocked around if you toss it in a backpack. If you want an absolute top-of-the-line USB fan, well, this is probably it. If you want to get notified of new videos as soon as they're up, hit subscribe, then click the bell icon to enable notifications. So guys, if you like this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit subscribe. And if you have any questions on the Z2-3D or the fan, for whatever reason, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, I hope I helped, and I'll see you in the next video.